Right, you ready, Tim? Thumbs up from Tim. Not sure I'm ready. Right, make sure it's in forward first. Most important. Right. Hi, everybody. Richard again here from Electric Classic Cars. And in this week's episode, I've done something rather silly.
Not the first time?
Nope. And it won't be the last either. Because what I've done, I've taken my already ridiculously quick Land Rover Defender and I've upgraded it. So hopefully in this video, we're going to see if this is the fastest Land Rover Defender in the world. Now, I'm going to start by giving you a quick summary of what I've done to this Defender, because if you want a more detailed picture of what I've done, there's an episode we've done previously which lays out the whole kit that we put in it. But in short, what I've done, I put a 100 kilowatt hour battery pack in this out of a Tesla. I've also taken the Tesla drivetrain and put that in the vehicle as well, but kind of done a little bit of jiggery-pokery to fit it in. And we've got CCS rapid charging on this as well. So that's kind of, you know, the headline figures of what's in this, but you want to know what I've done to it more recently. So let's get into that. Now, what have I done to this lately then? Why am I doing this episode? Well, in short, I've upgraded the controller to be a new controller. Previously, this had a board inside the motor. So we took out the original Tesla board, if you like, and put another board in, which controlled the motor according to whatever parameters you programmed in there. And that was great for the time that we used that board, but things have moved on and the latest technology we're using is actually fooling the Tesla motor into still thinking it's in a Tesla. So we're leaving the original Tesla controller inside the motor and we're just sending it CAN messages to kind of fool it to think it's still in a Tesla Model S or a Model X. So what are the benefits of doing that? Well, number one is drivability. So this throttle response and the way the regen comes in is exactly like you're in a Tesla, really nice and smooth, like an OEM should be. So that's benefit number one. Number two is setup. It's literally plug and play. There's no playing around with settings, trying to like tune it to get it to work right, which can take weeks, if not months, to really get spot on. This is plug and play. So that's a massive benefit for us as a business. And thirdly is efficiency. Because we've done some tests on this new controller versus the old controller, and because this is using the original, you know, highly efficient way of controlling the motor that Tesla use, we found that we're getting around about 5 to 8% more range because essentially it's more efficiently controlling that motor. And fourthly, and one of the reasons why I'm here on like private ground, is I have a sneaking suspicion that it's also more powerful. So without further ado, let's test that theory, shall we? Jesus! That's mental! Oh, that's insane, mate! Honestly, man, I've never four-wheel spun this before with the other controller in. So this is definitely quicker. I want to do a 0-60 now. Come
right,
on.
Right, let's go and do that.
Let's go and do a 0-60. What do you did it look good?
Oh, it was phenomenal. Phenomenal.
It felt insane. Right, we've come to a little quiet stretch of country road and we're going to do a 0-60 test now. And just to explain, I've got a draggy. DRAGY, and this is a very accurate GPS device to measure 0-60s and quarter mile times and stuff. So I'm using that for timing wise. Now I should caveat this with the fact that it's very cold today. It's about 3 degrees. In fact, it's going to snow tomorrow, apparently, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So it's freezing today. We've got off-road tyres on, and not the road tyres that I quite often use, and we're down to 70% battery. So I'm not expecting this to be as quick as it used to be, quite frankly.
These are your racing driver excuses.
These are my, you know, this is straight out of page one of racing book excuses as to why I think this is going to be slower today than it used to be. The quickest time this did previously was actually not by me, it's by Matt Watson, CarWow Matt Watson. He did a 0-16 3.8 seconds in this previously in the summertime with the road tyres on, and it was nice and hot. But I'm still intrigued to see what it'll do, so let's give it a go. Enough. Woo! Wow, that was over quick. Oh, that's cold. Oh my god, that's got my heart going. Right. Oh, that's quick. I tell you what, that is quick. Right, time to see what it was. If my fingers can work. What train it was, Tim?
4 seconds.
Well, really? Is that right? Nope. Quicker. In fact, that is the quickest I've ever done. 3.67 seconds, 0 to 60. I have to get a close up of it. 3.67 seconds, and it's freezing cold today on off road tyres. Imagine what this is going to be with the road tyres on in the summer. 3.67 seconds, 0 to 60. Is there a quicker Land Rover Defender out there? So, with a 0-60 of 3.67 seconds, I think we verified it's pretty handy on the road. But with this new controller, we still need to check that it's good off-road. Because previously, click on this video for an off-road adventure we've done in the past, it was pretty nifty off-road as well. So, I've got a big hill in front of me here now. I'm going to go down there, just check hill descent mode works and things like that, to make sure it's still pretty spot on off-road. We need to do it fairly quickly because it's absolutely freezing up here and Tim's about to get hypothermia. Hill descent mode works! Now, it's difficult to explain how good electric or the controllability of electric is off-road unless you actually experience it. But I'm going to do my very best because I'm going down this hill now and I've got my feet off the pedal and the motor's regenerative braking is effectively acting as hill descent mode. And it's doing it thousands of times a second, whereas a petrol engine is a little bit clunky doing hill descent mode and, you know, traction control, because essentially the engine still needs to tick over and you've got like brake calipers going on and off and stuff like that. This is controlling everything from the spin of the motor, so it's seamless, it's so smooth. And all of that hill descent mode, I was just going down then, my feet were not on the pedal and it's so silky smooth. Now with hill descent mode, car will even drive itself. I can take the car for a walk. Even the sheep are impressed. Now, we're down off the mountains now, and I'm desperately trying to warm my hands up on this hot cup of coffee. But 0 to 60, 3.67 seconds, that's pretty insane. That is supercar quick. In fact, I got a mate of mine with a 2011 911 GT3 RS, and that's a quick car, but I've just checked on my phone now, and it's the same 0 to 60 as this. So is this the quickest Land Rover on the planet? I'm pretty sure it is. But it's the off-road capability I was a little bit concerned about, because I didn't know whether it's new controller, whether or not we're going to have a high enough regen level to be able to hold it on steep descents at a walking pace, but definitely proved that it can do that. So this EV controls controller, fantastic, really, really happy with it. But question to you guys out there, is there a car that you know of that has a 0-60 in the 3.6s and is as capable off-road as this Land Rover Defender? Answers below, please. And on that note, hope you enjoyed this video. I'm off to get warm, and I'll see you on the next one.